Hey y'all, so I am back at it with another story time. So this story time is one of my personal story times, which is the time I got bullied in high school. So yeah, the reason why I want to tell this story is to encourage young women who feel like they want to give up, who feel like they're not good enough, as other people claim they say. But let me tell you, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Now, it all started when I was, I think, 9th. I think I was in 9th grade, something like that, 9th. So, it was my first day at school and I was so excited. Had on my uniform, had on my pants, and my shoes, was ready to work. Because, you know, y'all, to me, school, education, is very important, but it's not easy living through 4 years in high school. Now, I was walking, it wasn't far from where I lived, so I was walking, going to school on time, and everybody stared at me like they haven't seen like a black person. The reason why I say that, because they were whispering something in my ear, something in their ear, and I overheard them saying, "Who's that ugly black girl?" And to me, I'm like, whatever. So I just brushed it off. So, throughout the years, you know, I was quiet. I didn't have many friends. I only had one or two friends because I keep my circle small, y'all. When I tell you I keep my circle small, I do. I only talk to people who I trust. So, I was doing my work. I was helping out one of my best friends. My best friend was getting bullied too. And we were quiet, we did our work as normal people would. And the next day, it started again. They said, "I'm ugly, I'm fat, I'm this, I'm that." And then, okay, a couple of days passed, I brushed up, and one day, it was these two guys. They were tall, because you know I'm short, as you can see. So they pushed me in the locker. And it was mostly girls who was bullying me at first, but then it was a couple boys too, so it was both women and women, girls and boys. And you know, it didn't affect me after a while, but then the bullying keeps continuing, and I keep getting messages on my Facebook, so I had to deactivate it, saying I'm ugly, I should get a life, I should go kill myself, all that stuff. So I didn't do anything, you know, just push it up and they activate them, and they continue, and I didn't stand up for myself until my senior year. So I was like, okay, this has to stop. So I went to the principal, they didn't do nothing. Well, they tried, but they're telling me to ignore it. I told my teacher, I really love my teacher, because They're really nice and I miss them. But I'm still in contact with some of them. So she was like, okay, this has to end right now. And then finally I told her, no, I got it. So I started to defend myself. And to me, the first time I defend myself, it feels so great. When you defend yourself, you feel you have the power over them. So then after I stand up for myself, they call me fat, ugly. Well, no, and I just told them just one word. God loves you. And what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And after that, they leave me alone. I still get bullied up to this day, but you know, I'm saved, I'm a Christian, so I don't let things worry me like they used to before. Because used to before I was depressed. Not in that depressed, I never think like, oh, I don't want to live. But I made it all day school. And after a while, oh, I got a message saying they're sorry or some crazy thing. I just blocked them. I blocked them out there. And one of the things I should do to block out is to block out bullies, block out negative people, just keep positive people in your life. And yeah, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. So all those who just bully, who think, oh, their life is important, remember, your life is important. No one can live your life but you. So yeah, made all the path and move on from that. And yeah, right now I'm doing college courses online. Studying psychology. And it's a struggle to do online class, but the reason why I chose doing that class is because it would be easy for me. And it's hard, but I'm gonna get through it. And if you put your mind to what you do or what you want to do, I want to become a social worker. And the reason why I want to become a social worker is to encourage not only young women but youth, so whatever your dreams or goals are, go for it. And I'm 21. No education is important, and it's just that I know some people dropped out because they get bullied, but don't let them bring it down. And to me, online, well, is more easier for me because you get to experience what it's like to learn for yourself and not have noise in your head, not have people bugging you, poking you behind the neck. Guys, I've been through in high school and then over that, and yeah, I'm in on my second semester, I think. Yeah, second semester now. Still have a whole lot to do, but I'll make it. And a lot of people say I won't make it in life, but I'm here trying to survive, trying to do what I can do, not only for me, but you know, for my family. I love my family. They've been a great support. And the reason why I say that is because at, what, 12? Yeah, I was diagnosed with diabetes. So I'm giving you guys two stories now. So I was diagnosed with diabetes when I was So this was in my primary school years or secondary school years. I was 12. Yeah, so I couldn't like concentrate. I couldn't do certain things. I just wouldn't concentrate then. And then I went to the doctor. And my sugar was high. So it was 300. So I was allowed to stay for like 2 days in the hospital. And I didn't know what diabetes now, but the more I grew, the more I learned. I researched and realized people can live with it if you just cope with it and live by it. But it's hard when you have diabetes, because diabetes is like I eat too much sugar is in their blood. It's not good. Like, they give you this thing to test your sugar, right, in the needle, and you have to test your sugar every day. If it's 80 to 100, that's normal, but if it's 200 to maybe 300, it's good. And the way you need to stabilize your sugar is by not eating a lot of sugar. Make sure you're on a good diet. Make sure you're active. And not only that, it comes with there's a lot of stuff. But yeah, it's like when something in the mornings I can't think of it, but like you can get heart problems, you can get obesity, and that's basically what is affecting the world right now. And for me, it's really struggling. I'm still struggling with it. Got it for like what, 5 to 6 things, but I'm getting better with it, you know. Go to my doctor visits, everything was good. And yeah, I have type 2. It was type 1, and they said it was type 2. And all that stuff. But and another thing I was diagnosed with was Turner syndrome. Turner syndrome has to do with like when two women has two X's, two X chromosomes. But I only have 1.5. Yeah, but you have to look it up. It's called TURNERSYNDROME. I'll write it down in the comment section. And with that, you can't have children. That's part of it, but you can adopt. So when I heard that, I was a little shocked. I'm still young and free and single. Don't got time for that right now. But yeah, just living life, working hard. I don't have the best job right now, but my family is proud of me and I'm proud of myself. And the symptoms of it is like short stature, as you can see, I'm sure, web neck, web feet. But if you want to learn more, I have a link so you can look up what diabetes is, what Turner syndrome. So those two things I have, and pretty much they say I'm doing good, I'm doing very well with it. And they put me on estrogen, and that's what keep me motivated. It's stupid because that helps you develop more. You know, because I didn't see my menstrual until I was 18. And this is TMI, but it's real. And now I see it every month, and for 5 days, and that's part of living. So yeah, that's what I gotta say. Like, whatever you're going through, no matter if you're short, whatever, love who you are, tell yourself you're strong, and whatever you want to think. And shout out to all my TS sisters, shout out to all my diabetes sisters, they're all strong. And if you have any questions, you need to ask me about diabetes or autoimmune syndrome, let me know. But the most important thing is your life, is what the doctor told me, is people with Turner syndrome, they don't live, meaning some of them live, but most of them don't. And one thing they said, I'm a mirror, and to me, no matter whatever they say, people say, whatever disability I have, or the stuff I know that I'm stopping from falling, I'm falling in the dreams, don't let them. And one of the things they said that I have, we have people with Turner syndrome, they have like learning disabilities. But I'm a smart girl, I might not be an A student, but hey, I graduated high school, I'm in college, still struggle, I'm struggling, but I'm making it. So yeah, I just wanted to tell you all, hope this video is not all over the place, but yeah. So this is my view. So I wanted to do a little vlog. Just by the window in the kitchen. But yeah, y'all, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. So remember that. Love you guys.